Portuguese soup uses really simple ingredients. We've got onion, onion, garlic, potato, chorizo, it's kind of a smoked pork-based sausage from Spain, and kale. Now, if you can't get kale, you could use cabbage, but to be honest with you, any supermarket you can pick up cabbage, the kale's going to be right next door to it as well. Alright, so first job, jump.
Yep.
Roughly chop that.
I will.
It doesn't have to be too precise because we're going to blitz the whole soup at the end. And Tom, if you can start on the chorizo, again a rough cut of dice with that. A bit of garlic as well over here.
That's quite hard to cut through.
Top tip with the garlic, don't bother spending hours and hours and hours peeling it. Just squash it. Take the ends off. Ideally a bigger knife, but just squash it and the casing will just fall off.
Is that finely chopped enough?
If we get a little fine. See, basically, once the soup's on, it's really simple. As soon as you've got the ingredients in the pan, you're good to go. Now, we're actually going to liquidise it, but traditionally, in Portugal, it wouldn't have been liquidised. So we've got a pan heating up in the back here. I'm just going to place a couple of tablespoons of oil, vegetable oil, doesn't need to be any more than that, corn oil, like that, sunflower. As soon as the onion's good to go, it won't be long. That's going to go in the pan. Oil. And we're just going to fry that for 5 minutes or so until it becomes translucent.
When you say translucent,
see-through. Yeah, soft and sweet basically. Potato times, we'll stop with that. We're looking for, we've got one already on there, but just another one to add to it. Two large potatoes, just roughly chopped.
When buying food, I'd say 5 per kilogram. So if there's 2 bags of pasta or pasta, you see not just by price, the cheapest one, because they're different weights in the bags.
Try and cook together because it's cheaper and it's more social.
You want stuff that's going to last and isn't going to just go off because you don't eat it, because you're not going to eat a meal every day.
Have a good job?
Yeah.
These are done now, Ben, I think.
We're going to throw the chorizo in now. You get a lot of oil come out of the chorizo as it fries. And the garlic can go at this point too. It's not worth putting it in the area, because the garlic's more likely to burn than the onion will. Just fry those in. Another 2 or 3 minutes frying, just release all those oils. And then we're going to add the potato and the water, cold water, and bring that to the boil to cook the
potatoes. Right now, what's that, Ben?
You can see
the potatoes in now.
You've got a nice colour on those. I'll show you the camera.
Okay, just the line. Put the potatoes in slowly, one by one.
Come on.
One by one. And then, when you've done about 5, just let the flavours infuse. Put them all in.
With about 1 litre of water as well. And that's going to cook. And then just put it back on the stove, bring it back to the boil, just cook the potatoes. So that's it, you've got 15 minutes
now. Now, drinking isn't a vital part of university life. If you don't want to drink, you don't have to. Don't let anyone force you into drinking. That's totally fine. But, you've got to remember, if you are going to drink, you want to learn how to be able to drink quick. I've been there for 2 years, I still can't drink quick. The way I recommend getting around that is, firstly, don't drink anything that's too gassy. If you're going to have a pint full, go for things like snake bite.
It's been about 15 minutes. Since we put on the boiling water.
Well, the best way to check is take a little bit of the potato out, just break it with a fork. No, it's cooked, and we're ready for the next step.
So, what is the next step, Ben?
Kale, in you go, all of it in. Good. It's got to be boiling nice and rapid to do it. Put it straight in. You don't want to cook the kale for too long, because you'll lose its colour, nutritional value. I am vitamin A and E, that's why we're using.
It's good for your skin. It's
very good for your skin. That's great. Make sure it's all.
A couple of minutes now, so we're good to start blitzing it.
The next bit, soup's done. Start to blitz it.
Alright,
just want to ladle in there.
Oh, I've got a Tommy, you know
what to do. Just pour that through. Again, you can eat it like this, depending on how fast you want to go. Tom, start it, moving that through there. You can eat, depends on how smoky the chorizo was, but a little bit more smoke. That brim in there. And we haven't put any salt in it yet, so we're going to do it.
Okay. Can we try it, please, then?
Okay, that's improved it.
Yeah, and then we'll try after.
Nice crusty bread.